Hey guys, what's up, man? Today I want to talk to you guys about the creative design of these military Jeeps today. I showcased them a bit on one of my last videos when I was here at the gun range, but I didn't get into any serious detail. So today I just wanted to talk about the creativity and the design of Jeeps and how they play an important part in our everyday life, military life, and just recreational vehicles in general, right? But these vehicles are classics. I mean, they're really old. Nobody really drives them. That's why they're here on display, really at this sort of like a museum display, right? As you can see, the inside has been rusted out. These Jeeps were used for war purposes and survival. As you can see, they have like a lot of the survival equipment here on the US Army on this particular Jeep, like a pulley that can also be used to pull the Jeep out of a swamp or a situation that may be detrimental to their lives, right? So all of these are design elements that artists, engineers have come up with to help navigate through turbulent times. And there's like three of these different Jeeps on display here at the gun range. For those of you who really know more in detail and depth about the mechanics of the Jeep, you can leave your comments below. I'd be more than happy to hear your feedback on that. I'm not here to talk about that so much, but more of like the design aesthetics, right? So just coming up with a concept of a vehicle, a utility vehicle that could be used in situations to get you through some terrain that may be like tough or tough to get through. And of course, like with modern technology now, right, the Jeeps are a lot more advanced, more equipped. But this was some hard living right here. I mean, these Jeeps have seen some tough days, I'm pretty sure. And as you can see, like the bare minimums, right? They're just the essentials. But it just goes to show you the evolution of how far things have come since then. And this is like this with design in general, right? Like a lot of times they may complain of, why isn't it better? Why isn't it this? But we have to go through stages in design. And design, we call these iterations. So iterations may be like, you may do a first design and it may be a rough draft. It's not completely finished, but it's a rough drive, right? It's your first iteration. And that's kind of like what I'm using these examples for with these Jeeps. So when you're designing something, it may not be the best, but it's the best at that time, right? At that moment, until you do like user research, right? And then you come up with a new iteration. And then there's another iteration. So I just wanted to use these Jeeps as examples to really have a design conversation from an artistic standpoint. And a lot of these design aesthetics are very basic, right? They're, again, I talked about, you know, not so much of having in today's modern technology. So someone may look at this and be like, why is he showing these old Jeeps? It's useless. I don't think that way when it comes to design. It's never useless. We all have to start somewhere in life. And that's my point I'm trying to show here with these Jeeps. We started here and now things have advanced to much better stages, right? Where there's sensors and things of that make a bit more comfort, right? More comfortable. And now you don't even really have to drive the Jeeps. You can send drones. I mean, that's how advanced the technology of today has come. You don't even have to drive it. You don't necessarily have to drive anywhere. You can just send a drone. But it just goes back to show you that the mind, the creativity in the mind, it's endless. Just to come up with something like this during the time, this was the best of its time. Of course, you know, it may not be what we would go out, you know, with now, but during the time, it was the best of its time. I mean, just to have like the design concept of having canteens on just places in which you can store things. All of these little design elements, like an antenna. Of course, you know, for those of you that used to have to use a CB can understand the importance of an antenna. But now with cell towers and G5, I mean, you know, all this stuff is obsolete, right? It's non-void. But keep in mind, had we not started here, we wouldn't be where we are now, right? So my point to every designer, every aspiring artist, start somewhere, right? And then from there, you can always make iterations and improve upon what you currently have to make things better. That's my point of this. It's not so much to talk about the aesthetics of its performance compared to today's world. That's not the point of this video. This video is to show you how things can start and evolve, right? So it's just to get you inspired, to motivate, to do something, to start something, and as opposed to saying, oh, it's not good enough, so therefore you just give up and you don't start at all. You have to start somewhere. And just like these old-fashioned Jeeps that may be useless for today's world, and they're just sitting here as, you know, monuments of the past, this is great. We all need to know where we come from in order to determine where we're going, right? So again, start somewhere, right? It may not be perfect. It may not be exactly where you want things to be, but you have to first start and then iterate from there. Make changes from there, make improvements from there, and things will be eventually, they will evolve and they will get to the point where you're like, wow, you know, look how far we've come. So that's all I'm trying to do here is motivate others to start. I knew as a young designer, I would draw things like this that I saw on television or in magazines, and not understanding all the mechanics, right? I leave most of that stuff up to the engineer, but just designing the shapes, starting with simple things like that, right? And then evolving to like, oh wow, I want this to look like this. Then you can get into more of the design aesthetics, but you have to first have a foundation, start with a base. And that's the purpose of what I'm trying to get through to you guys with this video. I'm trying to inspire creativity. And creativity starts with a mess. It starts out messy. It's crazy. People don't understand it. What is that? What is that? That looks like garbage. You know, that's useless. But that's how it starts. And then from there, we begin to shape and mold things to the way that we ultimately want them to be. All right, guys. So start first. It doesn't matter. It may not be what you want right now, but continue to make iterations. Iterations means changes. Continue to make changes to your design concepts, to whatever it is that you started, and things will eventually get better. That's the point of this video. And if you want to support the channel, you can purchase one of my custom designed t-shirts. Today I'm wearing the t-shirts from the Philippines. So every video you see me in, I'm wearing a t-shirt, a Hilderbrand lifestyle t-shirt. And you can support the channel that way. If you know, you don't want to buy a t-shirt, that's fine. Just hit the thumbs up. And if you're new to the channel, please like, share, and subscribe. All right, guys, I hope you find this helpful and inspiring. And remember, just start. Start to design, start to create. And I know it may look messy, it may look crazy to a lot of people in the beginning, just like these Jeeps do now, you know? But trust me, when these Jeeps first hit the market, man, it was the everything. It was like, wow, right? But you're looking at it now and it's like, you know, to a lot of people it's garbage. You know, I found it to be classic. And I always like to look at, a lot of times I like to look at the sketches, not so much of the finished product, but the thought process. And that's what you get from when you're looking at people's sketchbooks. A lot of times, you know, when you're making a sketch, you're going through a thought process, a thinking process. And to me, that's more important than the finished product a lot of times, because during that process, your thinking process, right, is when you're, it's when you're conceiving an idea. You're coming up with it, you know, you're giving birth to something, you're thinking about, man, if I could just, what if this could be, what if that could be, right? You're dreaming, right? It's nothing, nothing is written in stone as of yet, but that's where it all starts. So continue to dream, continue to use your imagination, and continue to create, regardless of how it looks in the beginning. We can always make iterations and make changes and make improvements later. So just get started. All right, guys, have a great day. Thanks for your time watching the channel. And until next time, peace, love, and everything. All right.